I remember what the prayer was yesterday. I'll think good thoughts. I'll say good things. I won't say what I really want to say.
We all know him as a man who speaks his mind. Deputy Majority Leader John DeFrancisco joins your voice. I'm Julia Lilkindy.
That was a little bit of a misquote. I couldn't quite tell myself to, you know, watch what you say, because I just say what I think is right. But there was a Buddhist priest who gave a nice sermon the day before. And so I was trying to keep things a little cooler than mine had otherwise been, and it turned out fine.
Yeah, so that was your bill to create a commission on prosecutorial conduct.
Correct.
And when you said you were retiring, I asked you, what bill would you want to make sure gets enacted if you had your choice? And you said this bill.
Yeah, this is long-ranging effects. And basically what the bill is, it's a bill that provides a remedy against prosecutors that are not following the rules. And it happens. There's people going to jail on murder cases where evidence is being withheld, or even lesser cases where evidence is being withheld. And the law says you got to disclose it. And there's some instances where people have stayed in jail for years, 10 years, 20 years. And ultimately, by DNA evidence, they're proven not to have been the case, the perpetrator, and that DA's office had documents that would have shown it and information that would have shown it, which is just pathetic. Well, we've had a judicial misconduct committee, judicial conduct commission, since the 70s. And that's the reason it went in, basically, an avenue for an independent evaluation of alleged misconduct by judges. When it happened in the 70s, everyone went apoplectic. All the judges thought it was the end of the world, but it wasn't. As time went on, it changed judges' conduct. So they followed the rules because there's a threat of some type of consequences. And that's all it is. And the DAs also now are going up, getting very upset about it. But it's not an indictment on any DA. It's a review process for those who aren't following the rules.
Right. So people did say that they thought this might politicize the process.
They did. People can say anything they want to say. But that's not the case. This case is, it provides an independent body. The Judicial Conduct Commission is not politicized. They're political appointees, just like in any commission that's appointed. You can't avoid that unless you want all prosecutors on it, but that's not the way it's supposed to work. So it won't be politicized. And all I can point to is the Judicial Conduct Commission, and all the evils that are being raised just did not happen. And all the concerns over time showed that it worked.
All right. Let's show part of the debate where you're answering whether there's evidence that there's an uptick in misconduct by prosecutors.
After the DNA rules were broadened to provide more DNA samples upon arrest for certain offenses, yes. And whether there's an uptick or not, this has been happening without consequence. And every single person should be subject to consequences and responsibility for their actions.
Will the sponsor continue to you?
Yes.
Is the sponsor aware that the New York State Bar Association's Task Force on Wrongful Convictions found 53 cases from 1964 to 2009, and that is 0.004 of 1% of all convictions?
I don't know that for a fact, but it would not surprise me. The prosecutors also told me that they are being reviewed, and there's punishment on the books. There's plenty of oversight on the books because they're subject to going before the grievance committees in each county. If anybody knows of a case where a prosecutor actually went before a grievance committee and anything happened, I'll give you $10, okay? I asked the prosecutors that 3 years ago. You say there's a sufficient remedy? There's a sufficient remedy? Give me one case. And what, you know what they told me? They said, we'll bring up tons of cases. Last year, nada. This year, nada.
Talk about that for a minute.
Well, when this bill was first put out 4 or 5 years ago, there was always this mantra that there is a remedy. Why create another one? And they claim that the grievance committee of the State Bar Association, which meets in every judicial district, not every county, and is a remedy. Nobody's ever prosecuted. Nobody's ever reviewed. No prosecutors are ever reviewed. And the reason is that there's local committees. Talk about politicized. The grievance committees locally are comprised of lawyers in the locality. And most lawyers in the locality practice law, and many of them practice criminal law. Can you imagine going to a DA to try to get a client a plea bargain because the evidence is weak after you've accused the DA of wrongdoing? That's why it doesn't happen. Secondly, the DAs found a situation about the second year when I was trying to get some examples.
When you had the hearing, and it got a little loud at that
moment. Yes, we did have hearings. So those that you didn't hear that argument, which usually comes up, we should have had hearings. Well, we had hearings.
Right.
But the grievance committee, there was this DA in St. Lawrence County that had all things going on and showing misconduct, at least allegations of misconduct. So they said, I'll show you how we do these things. And the president of the state Prosecutors Association said we're going to file a grievance against her. Terrific. So the following year, after they filed the grievance, I said, how's that going? He says, well, we haven't gotten any response yet. I said, I rest my case. I mean, it just isn't a remedy. And besides, it's got to be an independent body. And again, not to try to find problems in the prosecutor's conduct. It's to remedy those situations where it's actually shown.
Mm-hmm. Checks and balances.
Yeah, that's true.
So at a news conference last week, I heard that. Did you write a letter to the District Attorney Association and then didn't even get a response last year?
I got responses, but the responses indicated that what they said was the case they didn't have any evidence of. So they've always been responsive. They've always been very well willing to meet with me. And in fact, I think the reason it got on the floor, the group wanted to see John Flanagan a couple of years ago. And we had a meeting in John Flanagan's office. And I raised all these issues. And they gave the answers that I just indicated. And he's also seen that this isn't the case, what they're saying. So hopefully it'll get passed by the assembly, signed by the governor, and over time there's going to be fits and starts as we start this process, just like with judges. But in the long term, there's going to be, when you know you got oversight, you're going to be less willing to take risks about your reputation and how you handle your responsibilities.
Right. Another reason for pushback was it'll be a drain on time, resources, and reputation of prosecutors. But if you've gone to any of your news conferences and you see the people who are wrongfully accused and their devastating stories and their time, their reputation.
Well, it's a little difference when you balance things in government. You balance inconvenience and time versus time in jail for years.
Yeah.
The cases that have been shown over the past, and even in the minor offenses, even if evidence is withheld in order to get a conviction, and evidence is withheld, even in minor cases, it ruins somebody's reputation.
Mm-hmm.
So I just think it's a good bill, and fortunately, a majority of the Senate felt it was a good bill. It was more than 2-1, almost 3-1.
Yeah, actually, 44 to 12.
Yeah, actually more than 3-1, and around 3-1. And then Democrats and Republicans, it was a great debate because all sides weighed in. It wasn't a party line vote. Mm-hmm. And now it's going to go to the Assembly.
Right. So what do you expect the Assembly to go?
I would hope so.
I
would think so. Yeah. They've been just as interested in getting this bill on the floor as I have.
So New York has an opportunity to set the course for the country, really, in this.
Well, it could set the course for at least prosecutions in the state of New York. And I don't think by following the rules, you're going to have less convictions. And if you do have less convictions, it's because you don't have the evidence. And that's what the rules are supposed to result in. So I know the prosecutors are not happy with me, and that's part of being a legislator. You can't make everybody happy. You got to do what you think is right.